Hi to anyone watching. So, what I'm going to talk about today is, I'm finding it really difficult, and I think it's important to speak about how to build resilience during times of stress, how to build resilience during any period of your life, because when you are suffering from mental health, you often, well, I feel like I often forget the power of my own mind to heal itself, and by that I mean the power of my mind to decide that I'm gonna, for example, see my friends and distract myself. I'm going to get out my sheets from therapy and go over things. I'm going to go home for a weekend instead of being on my own at uni. And the power of choice that still remains even when you feel like it doesn't exist. And I think that resilience comes in and strength comes in when time after time things seem to go wrong, or things seem like they are not getting any better, and choices along the way that you're making are moving you in a positive direction. So yeah, those choices to reach out for help, those choices to not isolate yourself, those kind of patterns, I think what I'm trying to put into words is to learn yourself, to get to know yourself, to get to know your triggers, to get to know what makes you feel better, even when you feel like nothing in the world can make you feel better. There must be something, and if there isn't, trying anything to see if that does work, or at least you know that doesn't. So that can go in that kind of list of, this thing definitely doesn't work when I'm feeling down. Getting to know who you feel most comfortable speaking to about your mental health and your behaviours, and how to reach out for help in a way that isn't scary and in a way that just feels safe. And I think it's something that I've been trying to do a lot, is just building myself up and trying to prepare myself for, not prepare myself, I think I mean like make sure that if something does happen, if something out of my control happens, that I've got these barriers and these safety nets in place, so that if my eating disorder behaviours slip back, which I feel like I've been experiencing recently, I am not alone and I'm not starting from scratch reaching out. And it's definitely not an easy thing to do, and it takes time, but I think when you have that resilience set up, it's such a safe feeling that although things do not always go to plan with mental health, and that's something that's really important to recognise, that it's not something you can plan for particularly, that you'll be okay and that you can work things out and continue to move forwards in a way that's healthy and in a way that's positive. It's so strange hearing myself say that, because I've definitely not been feeling in the most positive headspace recently, and here I am saying that, things can get better, and I'm a firm believer in that things can get better and things do get better. But definitely it's about learning how your own mind works and learning what works for you, and learning what doesn't work for you is really important too, and putting measures in place to kind of look after yourself. Because even though behaviours that I thought I'd overcome, I thought that I would never have to experience again, have kind of crept back up. I initially felt really angry at myself and really upset and such extreme kind of, yeah, hatred, because I was angry that I'd failed. I was angry that I had been through therapy and been through treatment and still wasn't fully recovered. But I don't think that's how mental health works. It's about learning how to manage your own problems and learning to be more gentle with yourself and continue to move forwards, I guess. So, I don't know, I think I just wanted to kind of pull myself out of a bit of a rut, really, and try and say something positive, because I know that, yeah, even during really difficult times, yeah, help is out there and resources are available on the internet, and even, yeah, even with a friend or a family member, you know, people are there to help. So I hope anyone who's watching this as well, and take care.